I'm just getting a letter off to Marine Barracks in Italy. Received through the chain of command, and it was signed by all the men and officers, I assume so. Full couple of pages of readings to me and support and so forth. And very nice.
I'm awfully glad you prefaced that through the chain of command.
Well, since it started out on January 20th.
That's the chain of command.
Sounds about it by now. What year?
All those things. <investors. laughs>
I don't know whether that goes back to the chain of command or the post.
That's quite the board in which
Fred
is.
Hello, Mr. Fred.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
This is my wife.
We come out there.
Nice to see you.
Daughters, Eva
and
Kim.
They want a picture of you and me over in front of the fireplace.
Okay.
And then after we do that, you will all come in and go in and put your fireplace.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you again, Mr. President.
Well, have a great night.
Certainly
thank
appreciate
you,
it. It was the honor of working with you.
Thank you.
Well,
exactly. Yes, thank you. Hello there. Good afternoon. Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, the same to you.
Welcome back to Washington.
Thank you. Hello there. My wife, Mr. President. Nice to see you.
And my daughter, Kim.
Kim?
My son, Wes.
Wes?
Mr. President, happy to
meet you. Nice to see you.
My brother Bob.
Hello.
Mr. President, well, the whole League of the Tribe.
Well, I think that's great. You and I will go in front of the fireplace for a picture, and then after we take that picture, you all come in and we'll have a picture.
Nice.
Thank you very much.
So could you come up?
Maybe between two of us, and then your face won't be hit.
There.
Okay.
That's good. Thank you very much.
Well, Mr. President, thank you so much.
For this.
Thank you for what you're going to do.
Well, we're excited about it. It's a great adventure. Honor. All of us are.
Well, good luck.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. That is a pin.
Jelly bean jars.
Jar.
Is
it? A seal on it and filled with jelly beans.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well,
thank you.
Good to see you. you will.
As I say, we will be in touch.
I know. Yes, we will.
President Dr. Yates.
Hello, sir. Very great honor to meet you.
And well.
I'd like you to meet my mother, Violet Yates.
I come from the other Washington.
Oh, well, I just came back and wished it was myself.
It's my father, Leon Yates.
Hello there, Mr. President. Nice to see you.
My daughter, Catherine.
Hello.
My son, John. Son, Paul.
Hello there.
And my daughter, Maureen.
Hello there. I have a daughter, Maureen.
Yes.
Well, you and I will go over in front of the fireplace and have a picture taken, and then you will all come in and join us for family pictures.
Thank you.
There, now, I want you all to come in. Just gathering a bunch like for a class picture. Well, thank you for what you're doing and
President
there, so you know.
Thank you, sir.
President, there is a pin that the National Seal on.
Thank you.
Our cufflinks.
Thank you.
Morning, young ladies.
Well,
I just did not have hands there.
There.
These are two young gentlemen.
And two tie bars.
Thank you.
There. Well, we will want you to forget us.
Well, we won't do that.
Well, good luck to all of you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks for
inviting us. Nice to see you. Well, great pleasure to have you here. Bye.
Okay, thanks.
John, hi. How are you?
How nice of you to do this.
Well,
everything great.
Well, good.
That says this.
Hello.
Yes, hello.
This is just wonderful. I can't believe it.
Right.
How are you?
Well, you're right all the time, too. People don't understand what you're doing. You're extra stupid, I think.
Trying to make this boy's going to post understand.
Well, we should be surrounded by all the other countries.
So you were so thoughtful to write me a letter about my speech at the UN on the Liberty of Phrase.
It was great. It was great.
That was
listen, great. You and I are going to go over and have a picture taken, and then you're going to join us for a picture.
Set.
Get right under old George here. And the only picture they tell me that was ever painted on without his wig. I know.
That's it.
All right.
God bless you. I hope you run again. God bless you.
Did I come in?
Sure, you
did.
Yeah,
yes.
Why not? But you get in the middle there between the speakers.
He would have wonderful tailor he had, doesn't he?
Oh, yes.
Look at that suit and that suit.
Oh, thank you so much. Much love to Nancy.
This is the belt buckle. Western belt buckle, in case you ever wear Western belt buckle.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
This is a little souvenir for you.
Thank you so
and
much.
Thank you for the high honor you bestowed on me. I shall do my best to vindicate. You have more than vindicated my judgment when I was chairman for you in Connecticut. I hope to vindicate your judgment in appointing me ambassador.
Well, I know you will.
We'll be working hard. We have a good opportunity
thank
there
you so
with
much.
All the Italians and the French. And
yes.
Yes.
Well, I sure will. God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Take care. You look wonderful.
Thank you. Sit down on this. You act like we're busy.
Yes.
Don't let him find out we don't do anything at all.
I just wanted to tell you I've been here now. Great challenge, the greatest challenge of my life. But and as far as women are concerned, I just wanted you to know that we're looking at that whole subject very, very carefully and trying to develop some new plans. And we hope we will be suggesting to you that you make a major speech on the subject of what you're you have done in this administration to advance the condition and the rights of women. It's been a superb record, and we think you should go forward publicly and speak about it.
They and the environmentalists, I don't think they're listening.
Well, they're listening. They'll hear there will be lots of women out there who will hear. And also, we're going to suggest that you make a speech on Mother's Day. Use one of your Saturday messages. Use the one just before Mother's Day to speak about the dignity of women and what they have meant to the American people. And to use every opportunity you can and all your public appearances to talk consistently and positively about your really fine record with women and not just restrict it just to a major speech. But I do think we need a major speech. I've discussed it with Jim Baker. And people are just crying as they did on the
phone. Congressman Bloomfield.
It was nice seeing the president. Thank you. Here's the
president, this is Christopher Rush.
Well,
hello, Mr.
Christopher.
Hello.
Well, it's nice to see you. You in here?
And Mr. Lewis, of course.
Hey, your team. Both in pinstripe suits.
Jerry. President, how are you?
Good.
My wife, Sam.
Pleasure.
Nice to see you and to have you here.
Thank you.
Good. Say hello to your family now.
Yeah, there's the Rushes.
Mr. and Mrs. Rush.
Hello there.
Nice to
see you, Mr. President. Delighted to meet you. Nice to meet you.
And Mrs. State, Mr. Bill.
Yes, hello
there. Their daughter, Amy.
Hello.
Mr.
President. How are you? That's fine.
Mr. Wood.
Oh,
Mr.
President.
Mr.
Chase.
Mr.
Smith.
Mr. Smith. I've had my picture taken by him a few times, too. Well, I'm very honored and pleased to have that. And very happy to meet you. And I saw something in someone's hand, but this would be kind of a duplicate. This is just a little jar, but it has the presidential seal engraved on it, and it's full of jelly beans. Oh. Maybe I'll give that to you.
Here, I'll have it. Well, that's tit for tat, my friend.
Yes. Believe me, I'll take them. as you can see, we really mean it. We're not just fooling about it.
Here.
And this is from my class.
Along with it, Mr. President.
Well, for heaven's sakes. Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah. Thank you and thank them. Well, I have their address there. I'll write a letter and thank them.
Hey, okay, almost for your meet.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is for Mrs. Reagan.
This is for Mrs. Reagan. I'll see that she gets it. Thank you very much.
It's a jelly bean scarf.
Well, yeah, we run the government on jelly beans. Practically all over the place in the cabinet room. You know, it's just wonderful. You know, this whole thing started as a joke. Well, it really started a little before that, seriously. I was addicted to smoking a pipe. And then when we began to realize that maybe smoking wasn't good for you, and I gave it up years ago, and I found that particularly in the evening, right after dinner, that was when I missed that pipe. And one Easter, someone sent us an Easter basket and some jelly beans. And I found that when I ate a few little jelly beans, I kind of got past that desire for the pipe. So when I became governor, I walked into the cabinet room, and there was a big jar of jelly beans right in the middle of the cabinet table. Nancy had put the press photographers poured in, and there was all the joking. And I didn't say anything because I'd never known anyone that didn't like jelly beans.
Except Bob Moretti.
But so I just waited, and pretty soon, you know, we'd have a cabinet meeting, and I'd take the lid off and shove the jar next to it. Well, then, to go on and see, big hassle and argument and debate and everybody this and that and the jelly bean jar coming down and the jelly beans and the jar. And pretty soon they were in every office in the cabinet. So you can imagine, when I came here, I didn't have to do anything. I walked into the cabinet room and there were two jars. So we still have them and everybody eats them. One day we had a visitor in here, a foreign minister from one of the Arab states. And I didn't realize that. I understand that candy, sweets or anything, are very hard to come by. We're in that part of the world. But we were sitting here, and finally we got up, and he was standing here, and I was standing there, and he was saying goodbye, and I was talking to him, but he was like this. And finally he says, can I have some of those? Another last story that I know I've got time to tell you is that in here, sometimes the press corps will come in, like there's a visiting head of state, and he'll have his own press with him, and our own press, and they just banked around here with the cameras. And when the Prime Minister of Japan was here, he was just sitting frozen, watching all this. And when they left, he'd been counting the Japanese cameras. No, exactly. Well, good to see you, and I know you've got a busy time ahead of you. But it's a great cause. This fellow here has been working at it for a long time. All right.
We're going to do great this year.
Thank you.
With your help, thank you, Mr. President. Just bring the give Nancy out of
it. I sure will.
Come on.
Thank you. Thank you for the presence and the message from your classmates.
Goodbye, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.